The innocent-looking word season hides a few secrets. And its story starts here, with the ploughman in the Roman Empire, the Sator. So this is a familiar figure. The farmer is driving his oxen along to plough his field, and he's not only well known because he was a common sight, he's well known because he was the origin of the famous Sator Square, Sator arepo tenet opera rotas, a Latin sentence which means the ploughman arepo holds the wheels with an effort. And the funny thing about that square is that it reads the same left to right to left, up to down, and down to up. A special little magic square. Now, Sator was the ploughman. The act of ploughing, or the act of sowing the field, was satio, and the stem in Latin, don't worry about that, will be explained some other time, was sation. Now, the season of ploughing or sowing was, of course, the spring. And eventually, ploughing came to mean the time of ploughing and came to mean spring. Sation came into French as saison and eventually into English as season. And by that time, it meant not just the spring, but any specific time of the year with specific weather. Okay, but there's more to it than that. What about seasoning for food? Well, when things are in season, they're ripe, and that means they taste the best that they will. Now, if you want to make things taste better, you add seasoning. Makes them more ripe or more appropriate to eat. And like that, you also have the idea of a seasoned competitor, a seasoned professional, someone who is ripe for the contest.